says that creating cards is a difficult task, it is one of the super easy and the easiest way to de-stress yourself. So I thought, why not to create some of the cards? And yes, this is one more series with my stamping, and it is again going to be a very basic stamping card. So today what I am going to do is, I have these watercolor papers. Yes, these are 120, 150 GS, no, these are actually, I think, around 180 GSM watercolor paper. These are cotton watercolor paper. This has a lot of cotton which soaks your colors really well. And I thought I will use this for my card making. And here I have some of the beautiful stamps from my collection. So let's get started. Now first I'm going to take one of the cardstock, and I need to choose the design, what I want to have. And I'm really sorry for my messy table, because I have been working on so many videos right now, because I'm traveling next week. So I had to finish so much of videos as early as possible. Okay, so here I've taken up this floral stamp, and I'm going to use a permanent ink pad. Now yes, when you are doing a watercolor card, you need to use a permanent ink pad or the pens which are waterproof, so that it does not smudges with your coloring. So can you see how beautiful this flower is? And I'm going to repeat this stamp all over my card. So I'm just doing the stamping, and I just want to make sure that I don't overlap my flowers and I do them well. Initially when I started crafting, I was not aware of the permanent ink pads, and I used to use all the regular ink pads even for the card making and stuff. And later on I realized that my cards are smudging, and then I read about permanent ink pads, and since then no looking back. I still use lots of dye ink based ink pads because I love them, and they are a must for every crafter, but you need watercolor permanent ink pads too. So here my stamping work is done. Now I'm going to have my color palette, and now I need to have water. So I am planning to make a card with a mixed color. So I'm just spraying water on my color palette so that it absorbs well, and I am able to use these colors. Okay, now I am going to have my water mug, and what I'm going to do is, I am just going to have my water on one of my flower, and you can see it's a permanent ink, so it is not going to smudge at all. I'll pick one color and I'm just going to spread it. As it's a watercolor card, I am not going to be very particular about the color and everything. Even it spreads out, it is going to look good. So I'm just going to spread this well. Okay, now I will move on to my next flower, and I'm just picking up the random colors. You can choose any of the colors you want and just play around. This is one of the very best and de-stressing activity which you can do. I love doing this, and you can always use these cards to gift your loved ones, and there is nothing better than handmade cards. So here my color was too much, so I added some more water and it's done. Now I'm just going to add some more water on the edges so that my color blends, and this is just to spread my colors out there and nothing. Just I'm having some water on my brush and I'm just spreading it, and you can see how beautiful it looks. This is just a natural color blending on my base. Now I will move on to Next shade, maybe I can pick up this orange color, but before that I need to add water to my flower. One tip, whenever you're working with your watercolors, make sure you have a clean cloth next to you so that you can clean it well, your brushes. It really helps. Initially when I started, I used to have a paper towel with me, but now as I am very comfortable with the watercolors, I really don't need that, but it really helps if you are a beginner. I think I need to add some more blue here. You can do as many layering you want, but you need to be really careful on how you are spreading your colors out there. Now it's time to pick another color. Maybe I can go for this yellow shade. Some more of orange here, and I'm just spreading these colors out there with some water. And even if your stamping was not good, don't worry about it. It is going to look beautiful because it is watercoloring and it is going to look fab. Now it's time to add one more shade of orange. Whenever you're doing watercolor, you need to make sure that you have a watercolor paper because it really makes a difference. And again, from one of my experiences when I started, I was not very sure of how well I will go with the watercolors. So I used to take any of the random colors, papers, and just do it, but I was not at all happy with the result. So the reason was, if your paper is not watercolor paper, watercolor based paper, it is actually not going to give you the good result, and then you might end up thinking that, oh, it is not working out. But it's actually a lot depends on your paper also. So here, one of my cute color background is ready, and let me dry this and I'll be back. Okay, so I'm done with my drying process and now it's time to stick this. So I'm going to use my liquid adhesive. Maybe I can choose some other base. I think this maroon will go well. Or yeah, I think this will go good with this design. Now I'm going to have my liquid adhesive on the back. And now I will stick this to my base, and I need to be a little careful here. And it's done, and now it's time to add a sentiment. So here I have this happy birthday. Whenever I make card, I usually make happy birthday card because I think these are one of the very easy and the coolest cards, which is really handy when you have to give it to someone. They are always a savior whenever you're going for a last moment birthday party call or anything, and I feel these are the perfect gifts what you can do. So now I will cut this, make a little bow kind of thing. It's just a random thing, and now I'm going to stick this here. Again, I'm using my liquid adhesive to stick this. The edges are pointed, so I'm going to make sure that I have my adhesive there so that it does not come out. And my sentiment is pretty. Maybe I should have a dark color backing to it. So I can have it on my black color cardstock first, and I will do the fussy cutting work. Like I always say, I love adding black color cardstock to my photographs, to my sentiment. Yes, it definitely highlights your sentiments. So I try to do this most of the times, or maybe I can disconnect this. I will just have these here and I will have it somewhere here on my card. Now again, I'm going to make sure that I stick my corners really well, especially the pointed corners, because they tend to come out over the time if not kept properly, and I just want to make sure that I stick it well. So here I'm sticking my sentiment, and my quick card is ready. And now it's time to make another card, and yes, for this again it's going to be really simple. What I'm going to do is I am again going to play with my watercolors, but please do remember this video is more about stamping, so how to use your stamping for creating easy and beautiful cards. Now in this I'm going to have my layers of water, and I'm going to add some colors to it, and just my brush up of watercolors, and adding some more water, adding some more shades, some more water, some more shades, just random blending of colors, and some more shade. This is so much fun. Some more water, and yes, some more shades. Now this is really quick one, just add the splash of water and blend it well. Now I'm going to heat dry it. My drying process, and now it's time to add some sentiment to it. So here again I'm going to use some sentiments here. I'm really confused, maybe I'll go with the happy birthday one only, and now I am going to stamp this, and I will do the happy birthday stamping here. And I think this looks great, simple and quick card. So I am going to have this on my card base. Now I will be having my liquid adhesive. So now if you realize, making your cards with these stamps is super easy. You just need to sit with your stamps, some colors and watercolors, and it's done. So here are my two quick cards, and I hope you like this. And yes, I have some more videos lined up. It's about decoupage, mixed media, crafting, coloring. So please stay tuned, and thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.